from this disease. That's the bad news. The good news is it doesn't...
Welcome to the hour of prayer, praise, and worship. Coming to you from Faith Life Ministry, this is Pastor Atwell and Bishop Vincent.
Let me prayer, hear the worship, praise, and worship. Worship.
Praise the Lord, a pleasant good night to you out there in Radio Land. This is Faith Life Ministry coming to you on another Tuesday night. It is so pleasant that brethren can dwell together in unity, and I know beyond a shadow of a doubt we are in unity in this studio tonight, and we thank God for you that are on the radio, on your television, on your computer, in your cars, wherever you may be tonight. This is the hour of prayer with Faith Life Ministry. We thank you for listening to us. Stay tuned, because we got something in store for you. The Holy Ghost got something in store for you. Jesus got something in store for you.
God bless you in Radio Land tonight. We greet you out there in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And we welcome you to tune in to Faith Life Ministry. And tonight, this is the hour of prayer. And we are coming to you live because we know it's not by might, it's not by power, but it's by the Spirit, said the Lord. So God bless you. Call your loved ones, call your friends, tell somebody about this program, and tonight, surely you will be blessed, because anytime you work for God, you got a reward, and just telling somebody about the program means a lot to God and to us tonight as we sit in the studio to meet your request tonight. So get ready. Take up your phone, call the studio, and let us have a good time in the presence of the Lord.
Oh,
Every praise is to our God. And we love to praise God because the Bible says He dwells in the praises of His people. And I know beyond a shadow of a doubt, He is worthy to be praised because He woke us up this morning. He started us on our way and He has been good to us and we are so grateful. That is why we give Him the praise. Right about this time, I want to ask Sister Monifa to open us in a word of prayer. Amen?
Amen. Amen. Good night, Radio Land. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord, for what you're doing in our lives, Lord Jesus. Thank you for your goodness, your mercy, your kindness towards us, Lord Jesus, God. Thank you, New, for allowing us to see another day, my Father. And God, I ask you, Lord, that even right now, God, that you'll touch the life of the listeners right now, Lord Jesus. I pray that even right now, Lord Jesus, that you'll make a way in their life where there seems to be no way, God. Because, God, the word says that you are the way maker, Lord. You are the truth. You are the light. You are the life right now, Jesus. So you are the only one that could change situations, Lord Jesus. So I pray for a change in their situation. I pray for a change in the mind of your people right now, Lord Jesus. So they'll come to know who you are even more, God. And they will give you all the honor and the glory that you so rightfully deserve, God. And I pray that even right now, that if there's anything in them that is not of you, that you will remove it right now in the name of Jesus, God, so that you shall be glorified right now. And I thank you, Lord.
Touch them.
Touch their family situation. If there's anything that is not of you in that situation, in their household, on their job, at their school, whatever the case may be, Lord Jesus, that I pray for deliverance in that situation right now in the name of Jesus. Nothing shall hinder your children from coming to you tonight. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
You are listening to The Hour of Prayer with Faith Life Ministry on Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice.
Every praise belongs to God. Not part of what we are doing But every praise, as we continue to praise Him, listen, while you sit by your radio, on your computer, wherever you are, and you begin to praise God, you can feel God's presence, because every praise that you give, none goes to your loved one, none goes to your husband, your wife, your children, your bosses. No one received the praises, amen, but God. So we have to, amen, He said, if you lift me up, I will draw all men. And sometimes you just have to lift up God because you want God to draw your children, your loved ones, amen, your relatives, your auntie, your tante. You want God to draw them. So what you have to do is just to praise Him, because He dwells in the praises of His people. So come on, as I told you before, we got something for you tonight that you can praise Him for, because we want the mind of God to get hold of you tonight, that you can worship Him in spirit and in truth. So get ready. Come on, don't forget this number. You can start calling us and sharing with us tonight. 347-663-8638. Remember, your life, your salvation, your choice. We want you to call us tonight and share this program with us. We open up the studio, open up the radio. Call us and share with us tonight, because something you said can reach the throne of God and souls will be blessed on tonight. God bless you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Rest in the arms of the Lord, and when all
It is so good when we have someone's arms that we can rest in. And this is not your wife's arms or your husband's arms or your mother's arms or your friend's arm. This is the arms of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, yes, the Savior of the world, the giver of salvation, the one who suffered and died that we might have life and have it more abundantly. Mm-hmm. Which other arm that we can rest in but in the arms of our Savior?
And you notice that the songwriter says, when you have no food on your table, when family and friends forsake you, you have an arm that you can rest in, Pastor Bash. You can just go to Jesus. He's there to answer. So there is no failure in him. Rest in the arms of Jesus. Man, when you began to rest in the arms of Jesus and satisfaction began to flow your way, you are feeling the sweetness of God flowing in your heart and you're saying, I'm resting in the arms of Jesus. And nobody will take me off, Pastor Bash. Nobody will take me off from the presence of God.
Yeah, David said it. He says, when my father and mother
forsake me,
the Lord will hold me up.
Yes. Amen.
There's a big word in the Bible that I love. It's called satiate. And when you rest in the arms of the Lord, that's what you find. And that you can get nowhere else. And the songwriter said it, when there's food on the table, rest. When there's no food on the table,
still rest.
Still rest. When sickness has your body just going in different directions, rest.
Rest.
Rest in him. Because you see, he said it, that he will keep us in perfect peace when our mind is stayed on him. Amen. And sometimes we want to define peace, but peace can be hard to define sometimes, because it's in the midst of war that you can find peace.
Amen.
And when we talk about perfect peace, and we think about Jesus in the boat rocking and him asleep, that's peace.
Yes.
So tonight I just thank God for you out there listening. We want to make a difference in your life. We want to decree what the Word of God says that you must have in your life. We want to decree abundant life in your life. Amen. Call us tonight at 347-663-8638. Call us and let us talk. Let us talk together. Come now.
Let us reason together.
Saith the Lord. Yes. Let us reason together. I don't know. Maybe we could get to love you even more when we reason together.
And if you have that peace in your heart, there's no reason why we can't reason.
Amen. There we go. Pastor Atwell is there on the move. God bless you tonight. 347-663-8638. This is Faith Life on the radio.
Amen.
There's nothing too hard for him.
It's really amazing how much of us feel that we're so strong and we're so powerful and, you know, we can do everything by ourselves and, you know, we're great and mighty and, but I soon found out, that there is no power without God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is no power unless you put your hands in the hand
of the man who stilled the waters.
That's why he said, God can do anything. Everything that you need from God, you can turn in and you can get it from God.
Mm-hmm.
What happened is that he supply your needs according to his riches and glory. And if we start to check the riches of his glory, we will not come to an end. So he has the big ocean that you can just plunge in and get satisfaction. Man, salvation is so sweet. Salvation is personal. Salvation is great. And when you asking God to come into your heart, amen, it's like a harvest time. You are saying, God, take this lump, take this old body, wash me and cleanse me. Oh God, I heard David said, amen, come God and purge me with hyssop, that I shall be clean. And God wants to clean us up. When we get clean up, Pastor, that's the time we're going to know that God can do everything and anything because we are in tune with God. Stay tuned. This program has a lot in store for you tonight. We are coming to you from Faith Life Ministry, located on 844 Clarkson Avenue. That's between East 51st and Utica, a family church where you will never be dissatisfied once you come out and worship the Lord with us.
Praise the Lord. God is good. And his mercies endure forever. You know, I thank God for his mercy.
Yes.
Amen.
Because, listen, you know, when I think about some of the things that men do, and some of the situations we see on the radio right now, Bishop, and we see on the TV, and we see on the internet, what's happening in this world today, we thank God for his mercy. Because as I was telling somebody this morning, Pastor Bash, if we were living in the Old Testament days, half of this world would have been wiped out by now.
The Bible says, men rather darkness than light because their deeds are evil. And in this world, we have so much evil deeds and man is turning away every day from God. I was speaking to a man yesterday and I had to tell him plain like this, I thought you had sense. I thought you was a smart man. I see you walk in the street all the time. But you were coming to my office to tell me that you don't believe in this and you don't believe in that. And you don't eat this. Come on, we got to be wiser than that and know in whom we believe. Know that God is able. If we do not come to an understanding about God, a lot of us going to pay a result. You know what the result is? You're going to bust hell wide open. You're going to spend your time in hell. But I'm thanking God. I'm so happy that there is a hell to shun and a heaven to gain. Somebody say there is no hell and no heaven. It's according to how you live. Well, I don't care about that. One thing I do know is only the born again, the blood wash, shall enter into the kingdom of God. And those who are not born again going to go to hell. That's what's happening. So we got to be careful who we serve in these last and closing. There's too much of technology is binding the peace and binding the world from the truth. But you don't have to stay in that. Come on, you that are listening to us, you take time off to listen to this program. God, we appreciate you for that. Why don't you get to your phone, call us, man, and encourage us. Share a testimony. Share a scripture verse. Somebody waiting for you on tonight. Stay tuned.
Sister Manifa, what's your destination?
Heaven.
Hey, she didn't even think about that.
There's no question.
And you're not fooling yourself.
Definitely not.
Because there's a way to get into heaven.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Christ, yes.
Right? Amen. Very good. Hallelujah.
That always that remember good. This. Your life.
Your choice.
Your salvation. Your choice. Make sure that you
make the right choice.
Make the right choice.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
The same song.
There's nothing too hard.
Is that just a good song?
For him.
A good song.
Not one battle he does not win.
This is just a reminder for you that to
Hallelujah.
Give God all your battles.
Bless the Lord. Hallelujah.
How are they, priests, that trouble me? They are they that rise up against me. They are they that say of my soul, there is no help for him in God. Set themselves against me round about. I will not be afraid of 10,000 of people who set themselves against me round about. For thou, O Lord, art a shield for me, my glory and the lifter of my head. For thou, O Lord, art a shield for me, my glory and the lifter of my head. I cried unto the Lord with my voice, and he heard me out of his holy head. I lay me down and I slept. I wait for the Lord, sustain me, sustain me. Now are they priests that trouble me? Many are they that rise up against me. Many are they that say of my soul, there is no help.
Praise the Lord. Good night to you on Choice Radio. This is Faith Life Ministries. Good night. Hello, this is Faith Life Ministry. Good night.
We lose that call. You better try and call back. Listener.
Just be glad. Yes, let them rejoice with gladness. God has triumphed by the means. Let God arise.
Caller, we would appreciate if you would attempt your call again. Sorry about that.
Shout the victory, rise this king.
marching on, and his army is ever strong, and his glory shall be seen upon our land. Raise the anthem, sing a victory song, praise the Lord.
When Monifa answered that question there on them before I as I finish,
okay,
you know, and I started to think, mm-hmm. you know, how effective that was, mm-hmm. and I realized, you know, while the song was playing that this Bible, the song is saying the captain of the host is Jesus, and mm-hmm. you know, you realize mm-hmm. that I can't piggyback on nobody.
Your salvation.
Yes, it's good.
No, you can't piggyback on nobody.
Definitely not.
You need a father, mother, bishop.
Nobody.
Apostle, whoever you may be, mm-mm. you got to make it on your own.
On your own. You know, it's good that you said that, because in the marriage, the vow is,
yes.
till death do us all
part. Yes.
Thank you very much.
And what
got to make it on your own.
You got to make it on your own.
And you know what brought to my mind when she answered that?
Instantaneously.
Spontaneously. Yeah. Yeah. You know what happened recently? The guy asked the question, are you a Christian?
Yes.
And you were shot instantly.
Yes. Yes.
You understand? And yes. you have to be ready to answer that question.
Yes, you have to be ready.
You have to be ready to answer that question.
Yes.
And as we go into our topic, we'll see exactly what that readiness, where that readiness comes from.
Amen.
And this is our topic for tonight. We're going back to what we were dealing with on last week, and we want to start a little earlier tonight so people can really get involved with us. Listen, call us in between our discussion. We don't have a problem with that.
Yes.
So you can call us while we are discussing the Word of God, because
Amen.
Your input can help somebody else.
Yes. Amen.
Your input can bring deliverance to somebody else.
That's right.
Your input might be something that will even strengthen us mm-hmm. in the studio.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. And we are going back to the word from last week. That is Romans 12.
Mm-hmm.
Romans 12, and we are going from verse 1 to verse 3. Romans 12, 1 to 3. And it says thus, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and the perfect will of God. For I say, through the grace given unto me, to every man, that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly, according as God hath dealt to every man the measure of faith.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
And be ye not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Bishop, I was looking at the dictionary today. You know, sometimes it's good to look at the dictionary and see what the dictionary is saying about the mind.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and dictionary talk about the mind as the cycle. And it was a strange word, and I tried to figure out what it is. And it really shows that the cycle is the thinking part of the mind.
Okay? Mm-hmm. I like that word.
Right? And it talks about the totality of conscience and unconsciousness, mental processes, and activity of the organism of the mind. So I realize here that you're conscious, you have a conscious mind and an unconscious mind. It deals with the mental and it deals with the processes and activities of the organism, which is your body.
Yes.
So your mind controls everything that exists on your body. So I started to think about the scripture. So when you renew your mind, you renew everything that in your body.
If any man
you remember
okay.
Right. Okay. Remember the word of God said, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things are passed away. So which means that we are living in a world, and when we accept Christ, we have to forget some things. You remember what Paul said, I'm forgetting those things which are behind and I'm pressing. So the mind becomes so important. Remember the Bible said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. And I love this one, who taught it not robbery to make himself equal with man. So you see, Pastor, what you're reading there is because of the grace of God. God's grace come and change our mindset.
Amen.
But then we have to accept. Those of us that accept and those of us that are seeing the change, we got to tell people. That's why the Bible said, go, lift up your voice like a trumpet and show my people the transgression. So we have it there. Changing your mind becomes the key to you and tonight. What do I change my mind to?
All right.
The program will tell you as we go along.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
And we look at the beginning of that verse 2, of and course. It says, be not conformed to this world. So I realize that being conformed to this world causes a process of the mind that is not too healthy.
No. Yes, definitely.
Because it will bring you into condemnation.
That's
Amen.
Right. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I like what it says too, even in verse 1. He says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice. Everything else comes after that.
Amen.
Everything comes after you have presented yourself as a living sacrifice unto God.
Go ahead.
And then he says, be not conformed. And in that same passage in verse 2, he says, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. I love it.
Yes.
Because I don't have to keep thinking them nasty thoughts. I'm serious.
Amen.
I don't have to do that. I can begin, but I don't have to feed it.
Amen.
Because I'm transformed. And because of that transformation, I know whom I have believed in. And I'm persuaded that he's able to keep that. And he tells me what to think on.
Amen.
What things to think on. So when I find myself going in one direction, I make a right turn. And my life is made easier. Because I look at somebody, have you ever looked at somebody and thought you know all mm-hmm. about the person? Mm-hmm. And you're dead wrong. Mm-hmm. You're dead wrong. Mm-hmm. And you say, Lord, forgive me. You know, let me, instead of thinking that way, let me pray for the person.
Amen.
And in that verse 2, he says, by the renewing of your mind, that he may prove.
What?
Is that
what
good?
Is that good? G-O-O-D. Acceptable, A. Mm-hmm. And perfect.
Yes.
Because you see, in our lives, there can always be a gap.
Amen.
A G-A-P.
Amen.
But when our minds are transformed, then we can fill the gap. We know who to fill that gap with.
Amen.
His name is Jesus. And then we can really live that abundant life.
One thing I love when the Bible says, let the mind that is in Christ be in you. I love the word let, because it indicates a choice. Amen. As Bishop said, we could choose to accept if we have a negative thought. We could choose to meditate on it. We could choose to let it affect our life. It's our choice. Or we could choose to let the mind that is in Christ be in us. Mm-hmm. And when you let the mind that is in Christ be in you, then you're going to be willing to subject yourself to the will of God. Mm-hmm. That's the only way you could truly be able to please God. And I also love when it says that we should present ourselves as a living sacrifice. Mm-hmm. Christ himself presented himself for our sake to be that living sacrifice. He died for us, so we don't have to live or walk in accordance with the world or be conformed with the things of the world. He made a way so we are able to live righteous and be in perfect peace and to walk in the fruits of the Spirit. Amen.
You know, Pastor Bash, I went into the dictionary and I started to look at a lot of things, you know, and the dictionary was saying your mind is part substance, right? Or a process that reasons, thinks, feels, wills, perceives, and judge.
Mm. Okay.
Mm. Now, when I look at those words, it reasons.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
How could you reason if you don't have someone to control that process that your mind states? Mm-hmm. Because why I say that, because you of yourself, if you reason on your own, 99.9% of the time your reasoning is out of whack.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So we need a mind change.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because the Bible says we were born in sin,
shaping iniquity.
Mm-hmm. Which means this mind is a sinful mind from the beginning.
Amen. Yes.
From the very beginning.
Amen. The process that this mind has obtained from birth is a sinful mind. And that all it can process during that time when you're born is evil and sin and wickedness.
Mm-hmm.
But in the world, you notice that some people are about to do something and then they turn around and say, I changed my mind.
Amen.
And not of their own.
Not of their own.
Not of their own.
You know, as you say that, you know what it brought to mind? Remember that account of the man with Abimelech?
Mm-hmm.
Abimelech with Sarah and Abraham.
Yes.
And he says, but I didn't do it, Lord, when God says, you better know what you're doing because I already put a curse. And he says, I didn't do it. He says, you didn't do it? He says, I did it. Because if God doesn't do it for us, we can't do it of ourselves.
Amen.
We can't do the changing.
Yes, because even we think about Nebuchadnezzar.
Okay.
Great king, blessed of God. But you know what? he changed his mind.
Amen.
He
Amen.
Changed his mindset. And the Bible says God hardened his mind that he couldn't even think for himself. So when we think about this mind, this mind have a tendency to uplift itself.
Glory to God. Listen, you're listening to the hour of prayer. Amen. Coming to you from Faith Life Ministry. Come on, get on that phone and call us and share. Participate in this program tonight, because listen, we want you to think, what is the mind? What kind of mind do you have?
Amen.
Right now, as you're listening to us, what kind of mind do you have? Call us and discuss it with us. Amen. What kind of mind do you have? Are you going to be prepared to do something tomorrow, prepared to do something later, and then sit and listen and say, I'm going to change my mind?
Hallelujah.
That happened.
Now, and you're right, Bishop. Now, because as the meaning says, you have a conscious mind and an unconscious mind. And from reading the Word of God, we were born with an unconscious mind. And it takes God to bring the conscious mind and cause it to
the potter. It takes the potter to take the clay and turn it around and break it and fill it and use it. It takes the potter to do that.
To bring the change of mind.
To bring change the change
it.
Of mind.
Change it on the wheel.
Hallelujah.
So
change
God,
it on the wheel.
Change it on the wheels. And God wants to change your life right now.
Hallelujah.
Whatever you're doing, whatever you're thinking about, God wants to change your mind. Listen, as we speak to you, the evil that you're thinking in your heart, that evil that you're thinking, your mind has gone contrary and you're thinking something, maybe of your family, your brother, but we want to change your mind
change
right
your
now.
Mind. Right
as you
now.
Listen to Hallelujah. This radio, call us on the air, 347-663-8638. Remember, it's your life, your salvation, and
it's your choice.
Make a right choice right
Hallelujah.
Now and change your mind.
Hallelujah.
You know, Bishop, and I just following up what you say, the meaning of the word in your concerning mind, it means you have the ability to perceive.
Yes.
You have the ability to perceive. What are you perceiving in your mind? Are you perceiving truth or a lie?
Remember, remember Cain, when he had his mind made up to do what he had to do?
Yes.
And God talked to him.
And he didn't receive
it. And he didn't change his mind. But he kept going in that ridiculous.
He became judgmental.
Hallelujah. And that's what we have to be careful about.
Yes.
How we use our mind.
Amen.
Because when we feed it the wrong thoughts, because we can feed it. Remember last week you talk about gird up the
loins
of your mind.
And this is why Jesus says, come, let us
reason together.
Hallelujah.
Because we have the ability to perceive.
Amen.
So he said, let us reason
together.
So if we are reasoning, I will perceive something, I will receive something, I will get something, I will accept something.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And that's where the change will come. Because all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, the pride of life, not of the Father, and the world passeth away, and the things thereof, but he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. Don't fool yourself tonight. The preacher is not going to put you in heaven.
No,
he's not that powerful.
No.
You can do it. You can put yourself in heaven.
Just change your mind.
He says, come and taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him. Hallelujah. And we're talking about conscious and unconscious. While you are asleep, you don't know what's going on because your eyes are closed.
Amen.
You don't know what's going on, but there is somebody who takes charge. Hallelujah. Takes charge of that mind while you are asleep. Hallelujah.
You know, and I thank God how we share things here. And you know, a couple months ago, Bishop, maybe about a year, could be about a year, the God revealed to me, and this is something I do every night before I go to sleep, and I ask God to take control of my mind and my spirit while I'm sleeping.
And that's why David prayed like that. He's prayed. What did he say? I will lay down in peace and sleep. He didn't finish it there.
No.
For thou, Lord, makest me to dwell in safety. Where does safety come from in there?
It's God.
He's keeping you safe from something.
Amen.
He keeps your mind.
Yes.
So that when you get up, you ever get up with a nasty headache?
Oh, yeah.
And you don't know, well, what happened? I went to sleep, I get up, I have a... And then
I get up with a bad dream. Amen.
You don't know what to do. But God.
And this is why Jesus said in Matthew 22:37, he says, Jesus said unto him, he says, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with what?
All
thy heart.
And what again?
And with all thy soul. And then he says, with all thy mind.
But I have a question, you know.
Yes.
What is the relationship between the heart and the mind? To me, they're very close.
They are.
Really?
They have to be.
Because the heart is the heartbeat of the mind.
Okay. All right. I'll take
that.
Right. I'll take that.
Yeah, because think about this way. If your mind is disturbed, your heart begins to beat very fast.
Thank you.
If you are in trouble, your heart begins to beat very fast.
That's
if your mind is confused, your heart begins to beat very fast.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
A troubled mind brings a troubled heart. So that's why he says God deals with the heart. He don't deal with the mind.
No, he doesn't.
So
he
if the heart is right, the mind will function wonderfully.
Remember
you're listening to Faith Life Ministry.
This is honey
coming to you from
the honeycomb.
844 Clarkson Avenue in Brooklyn. Call us and participate in this program. 347-663-8638. You have an opportunity to share your testimony or your prayer on tonight. Because even when we look at medical terms, and we look at when you go to the doctor, what they check first? They check your heart.
Corazón.
Yeah.
Because they check to see if your heart is beating right.
And that's true.
Because if your heart is not beating right, your mind function is out of whack.
That's correct. It happened to me.
That's why the Bible says it's not what goes in the man that defiles him, but it's what comes out. What comes out.
That's
why you have to be careful what you meditate on, what you let to grow in your heart, because it will defile you. And the Bible says, what you sow in the flesh, will of the flesh will reap. Corruption.
That's right.
But he who sows in the spirit will reap everlasting life. We want to reap everlasting life. That's why the Bible says we have to get those minds captive.
Yes.
Those minds we have to pull down strongholds even in our mind.
In
we have to
mind.
Make sure that even when thoughts that are not pleasing to God comes up, we don't spend our time meditating on it. That's why even when the Bible tells us that we shouldn't go to sleep in anger because we give an opportunity for the devil.
Right.
And we look at the scripture and we see where when Jesus was talking to his disciples, he always says, love God with all your heart and your mind. He always put them together because why he's putting them together, because they function one with another.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
If your heart is dirty, your mind is dirty.
True.
And remember that scripture that he gives us. He says he has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power. Of love,
of
a sound mind. So important to have
a sound mind.
You are waking up the mind of people.
Yeah.
The mind of the church.
Yeah.
The mind of everybody. Waking it up, because we think, and we began to think contrary And our mind goes contrary because of what we are thinking about. What you, as our sister said, what are we meditating upon? Something might come, you don't have to meditate on that. You got to change your mind. Right now, you are thinking something. You are thinking to do this, do that. Tomorrow when I get up, we don't have to go and get the mind led by evil forces. It doesn't, sometimes we doesn't want to say this, but we have Christian, did I say Christian? We got some church members who come to church on Sunday, have a good service, and Monday morning the mind changed from the service and they're gone to get the palm read. They're gone to see what the mind is about. You can take the word of God and see yourself. It's like a mirror. So you can understand what it is. Get to that phone and call us. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Good night. You're on Choice Radio, Faith Life Ministry.
Praise the Lord, brothers, pastors. I just want to speak briefly about the blessings and the healing that I received from the church. And I remember in the Bible where Jesus said, weren't there 10 healed? Where are the 9? The reason why I'm saying that, so many of us have received blessing, have had you people prayed for us, including me first, fasted for me, pray me through situation. Hospitalization, health problem, and I have been healed and I'm rejoicing because of faith ministry. And I'm saying so many of us, and we need to call in and encourage the people who may be afraid or timid to call in. But when God is blessing you, don't be afraid. Call in so other people will hear. Other people will know. Other people can be blessed. And this is all I have to say. I pray that people would call in and let others know that there's a blessing, there's healing coming out of your ministry.
Praise
and may
the Lord.
God richly bless you.
God bless you.
Father, we thank you for our sister tonight. Right, we pray that you will continue to keep her healed. You will continue to keep her delivered. God, and even as she testifies, God, you will take her to higher heights and deeper depths, and her testimony will be a blessing to everyone else in the name of Jesus.
In the name
she said, Pastor, that a lot of people came, get healed, got delivered, get help, and gone. In other words, what she was saying, they're not there. They change their mind.
That's right. They were 10 healed. We are the 9.
They change their mind.
God bless you.
God bless you. Right. Thank you for your call. It's an inspiration to us.
Hallelujah.
You know, because, listen, it's a mindset.
Yes, it is.
Some of us have this mindset where, give me, give me, give me, give me, give me. And when you can't give me no more, I drop you on the wayside. And we recognize that in the kingdom, Bishop, where people come, God bless them, and as soon as they get the blessings, they're gone. Something happen again, they come back again. You know? Because it's a mindset. This is why the Bible is saying, let this mind
be in you,
which was also in Christ Jesus. And if you don't have that mindset, you will always have to go and come back.
Amen. True.
Hallelujah.
That leads me in the scripture verse where it's from Galatians 5:1. It says, stand fast therefore in the liberty by which Christ has made us free. Do not be entangled again with a yoke of bondage. If your mind is not renewed, you're going to be in bondage again. The same bondage that Christ made sure that you were free from. And if you're spending your time meditating on evil things, you're very ungrateful, you're filled with jealousy, your heart is filthy with all of those things, you are in bondage again. It's almost like you're sacrificing Christ again.
Because they haven't had
a
A mind change.
A transformation.
A transformation. You see, a lot of us go behind the loaves and the fishes.
Okay, no.
And there's something that I say, we like the healer. We like the healing, but we don't like the healer.
All right.
We like the blessing, but we don't like the blesser.
All right.
Because we have an organism that bad in our mind.
And I have a question. Does the butterfly ever return, ever go back to be a caterpillar?
No.
The butterfly don't change in mind.
No.
That butterfly is set free, and there's a metamorphosis that takes place, and that butterfly stays a butterfly.
The only creature on earth that happens to is man.
That's why the Bible says, have your mind set and keep it set.
Yes. You know, remember when Jesus, he said certain things to the people that are following.
Yes.
And they changed their mind.
Yes.
Some of them changed their mind.
Yes.
And he looked at his disciples and he said, will you also go? And that's why we have the word that says, he that putteth his hand to the plow and look at back is not fit for the kingdom of heaven. And this is what we as church people stop wasting time.
Yes.
Stop
get a mind change.
Stop wasting time. You've done it again. Come on. Let God do the rest.
Yes. Amen.
God do the rest in the name of Jesus.
And I love when Jesus says in the Bible, he says that the world is going to hate us. World is going to hate those that love him.
Yeah.
And then he says, he prayed and he says that he wants us to be sanctified by the word, because the word is truth.
Yes,
and that's why in renewing our minds, we have to come back to knowing the word. If we're not spending time with the word, time with God, that means our mind is not going to be renewed. There's not going to be any spiritual growth. You're going to be stagnant. And you cannot, God don't want anyone that's stagnant, that's lukewarm. You're in one minute, you're out the next. He doesn't want that, because he said he's going to spit you out of his mouth.
That's what he says.
Hallelujah. So that's why we have to make sure that our mind is continuously being renewed. If anything, when the Bible says, my sheep, when Jesus says, my sheep knows my voice.
Hallelujah.
How are you going to know the voice of God if your mind is not renewed?
And on him.
And Isaiah said in Isaiah 26:3, thou will keep him in perfect peace.
Amen. Whose mind?
Whose mind is stayed on thee.
Not afraid, you know. But stayed.
But you see, that's the ending. I like that.
That
because
true.
He trusted
that's
in
correct,
thee.
Brother. You got it.
Amen.
Because he trusteth.
Yes.
Indeed. Hallelujah.
So
hallelujah.
This is something else.
Hallelujah.
Because it's a promise.
Promise. Yes.
He doesn't
trust
in the situation that looking at him.
No.
Trust in God.
He does not trust in God. He's seen the situation.
Yes.
But he trusts in the God that he know that can handle that situation.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
That can give him the correct mindset to deal with the situation.
Oh my God, that is so true.
We have to trust God to keep this mind.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Because this mind is a corrupt.
It's corrupt.
Piece of organism.
Yes, sir. Because you know how you know that too? The way you want to answer.
Oh, yes.
You want to answer.
Yes. So true.
You want to answer in a funny kind of way, you know?
Yes.
And you know, the scripture says in Proverbs 29:11, the fool
has said
in his
heart. The fool uttereth.
That's the scripture I know.
The fool uttereth his whole mind. I love that. You know why I love that? I'm from Trinidad.
Yes.
And when you mash somebody toe in Trinidad, and they say, don't let me give you a piece of my mind.
Yes. That's the whole mind.
Not piece, the whole mind.
Because it's relentless when they start. It's relentless.
You ever notice you do that and you feel you're so weak and so silly when you're done?
Yeah.
No wonder the Word of God tells us, be swift to hear.
And slow to speak. Yes.
And slow to wrath.
Amen.
That's how you keep your mind.
Yes.
Amen.
But see, at the end of that scripture.
Yes.
I love the end of that scripture. A wise man keepeth until afterwards.
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
So you take your beating, you take your tongue lashing,
and
you keep it in, and you prepare yourself for the correct answer.
Amen.
David did it. David did it.
Amen.
So get that mind changed and don't give nobody peace of your mind.
Amen.
Don't give nobody peace of your mind. Get that mind changed.
Yes.
Amen. And don't give nobody peace of it because it wouldn't work. We need a mind change to get to heaven. Listen, you're listening to Faith Life Ministry coming to you. Amen. The hour of prayer coming to you from Faith Life Ministry. Faith Life Ministry is a family church located at 844 Clarkson Avenue. That's between East 51st and Utica. And we want you to do, we're going to give you a special invitation this coming Friday in our deliverance service. Bring the sick, bring the lame. And there's so many people worried, having no peace on the job and in the workplace. And you can bring them. Come out on Friday evening at 7:30. We're going to have a special speaker. We're going to a deliverance service. Yeah. Headbang, where God can change your mind and give you a brand new mind. Hallelujah.
And according to Romans 12, we are speaking on behalf of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And tonight we are beseeching you.
Yes.
Urging you.
Therefore, brethren,
by the mercies of God.
Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
That mercy that brought you from this morning till now, listening to us on the radio, we beseech you to have a change of mind.
Amen. Amen.
Get a new mindset.
And
the only way you can get that new mindset is through the Word of God.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Let this mind
be in you.
Be in you. Which was also
glory to God
in Christ Jesus. Because it's He who came to give us that change of mind.
Hallelujah. Oh my God. No wonder the song says, oh, how I love Jesus.
Oh, how I love Jesus.
Oh, how I love Jesus. Because He first loved me.
Yes.
He left nothing out. Everything that we needed, He gave it to us.
Amen.
Everything that we needed, God gave it to us. And that's why we could live as we live. We could live soundly. We could live rooted and grounded. And when somebody comes with their nonsense, we could look at them and just say, But you have to be filled. You have to be filled with Jesus, the Word.
I got to ask a question here, Bishop. You may be able to answer it. You know, the Bible says, present your bodies as a living sacrifice. Mm-hmm. How can you do that? What it takes to do that?
Well, just what it takes is what is in the Word. It's what exactly is in the Word.
A renewed mind.
A renewed mind. You go to Him and you present that renewed mind unto Him. That's all I have. And that's a reasonable service.
Yes,
this is just reasonable God. He's not asking you to, you have to go and do all kind of a thing and pay all kind of money. But He's asking you as a reasonable service. So when you make that presentation, it's all finished, the pastor.
Amen.
I like that. Because the thief on the cross again.
Yes.
That's all he did.
Yes.
All he did.
And instantaneously.
Instantly. Yes, sir.
A change mind.
Change of mind.
Heaven is home.
Wow. Hallelujah.
So say, people out there. Let's, you know, we have been fun.
Let's reason.
Together.
Yes, sir.
Call us. Take up your phone and call us and share with us tonight.
You know, and you used a statement on last week, and it now come back to me again. A mind is a terrible thing to waste.
Yes.
Definitely.
You see it, man. Definitely.
You know, and the amazing thing is that we spend years wasting
our mind. True. Hallelujah. You know, many scientific minds go into hell?
Yes.
I mean, come on.
Yes.
Because why?
They don't acknowledge God. Yeah.
There's no change of mind. Mm. There's no transformation of mind. Mm. Because science ain't going to take you to heaven.
Nope. Mm-mm.
Listen, man, I realize there are some people that mm-hmm. are watching, listening to us right mm-hmm. now. I could say watching too, because if you're on a computer, you're watching and listening to us right now, that has a mind that they're saying, I got to make a change. I want to pray for you. We got to pray for you right now.
Yes.
We got to pray for you right now.
Yes,
right now. I want you just to think about what mind change mm-hmm. you want to make.
Yes.
What mind change? You heard us. You listen. And you know that if you change your mind from that evil,
yes.
that rot, that Hallelujah. Confusion, God will bless you. Father, mm-hmm. in the name of Jesus, Lord, stretch your hands out right now to those that are listening. Mm-hmm. God, this young man, this young woman,
yes.
this mother and father,
yes.
this husband and wife that are listening mm-hmm. and God want to change their mind. We pray, mm-hmm. God, that you will give them the ability mm-hmm. to change from the worst to the
yes.
better. Oh,
yes.
God, to change the mind from the world and take on the mind of Christ.
Yes.
Oh, God, that will
Hallelujah.
Bring them eternal life.
Yes.
Save, bless them.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus,
name of
we
Jesus.
Thank you, God.
Yes.
Listen, man, get to your phone and call us right now. 347-663-8638. You will never regret sharing something and telling us you accept Jesus Christ as your Savior.
Yes.
That's
Hallelujah.
All we are here. Someone
Hallelujah.
On the line.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Good night. You're on Choice Radio.
Good night. Thank you for your prayers. I've been listening to this station from 3 o'clock this morning.
Oh. Praise the Lord.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your consolation, for your nice words.
Amen. Amen.
I'll come visit your church someday, okay?
Praise
God
the Lord.
Bless
thank you so
God
much, my sister. Let us pray for you. Let us pray for you personally right now, you know, because and we thank you for calling. And
mm-hmm.
God has just said to me to pray for you personally.
Hallelujah.
God, you heard her heart.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
that's a heart,
God.
What she just let out there, God, because she is appreciating what she's hearing.
Mm-hmm.
She's grateful for hearing your word. Father, you know her heart, you know her mind, you know what she's going through even right now. You know her very thoughts, God. You know her feelings and
Jesus.
Her differences. And God, you know what's going through that home even right now. Let your power,
yes.
let your anointing flow through her.
Yes.
And give her courage, oh God,
mm-hmm.
to serve you in spirit and in truth. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you.
God bless
thank
you. Looking to see you on Sunday.
Thank you very much.
God bless
Amen.
You. Amen. Yes, we always have to rejoice when someone calls and when the Spirit of the Lord is leading us.
Yes.
There are people or they are listening. This is a big subject because
yes.
the mind of people, if the president changes his mind mm-hmm. of going to war, you know what will happen?
Yes,
if they change the mind of going to do what they're supposed to do, if they a lot of people looking for them to change the mind and don't close down the city, make sure that they get the salary. It's a mind. They got to know what they're about.
Mm-hmm.
And this is why we have to think about our reasonable service.
Mm-hmm.
You that out there, you have a God to serve. And all he's asking you to present your body as a reasonable. That's all he's asking you.
All he's asking.
And when you present that body,
mm-hmm.
you know, man, God giving you salvation
mm-hmm.
that you have a right to rejoice
mm-hmm.
and feel like us in the studio
mm-hmm.
because it's not by might, it's not by power, but it's by the Spirit, said the Lord.
You know, Pastor Bash and panel.
Mm-hmm.
God's word is so phenomenal.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
And
definitely.
It says that when I get a mind change,
Hallelujah.
Right? I have something to prove. I have something to prove.
Yeah.
That mind change
mm-hmm.
is good.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And that it is acceptable.
Okay, no.
And
that it's
perfect. And that it's the will of God.
That's
amen.
So I have something to prove.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
This is why he says to go ye mm-hmm. into all the world
and
preach the gospel.
Preach.
Mm-hmm. Because I have something to prove. Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
That I have a mind change.
Mm-hmm.
That I have accepted his perfect will.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Yep.
And I'm a different person.
And that's what Paul did.
Yes, because I have a change of mind.
And when you go out there,
yes.
if the Lord didn't tell you rain will fall, don't tell people God tell you rain will fall. You got to open up your heart and let God minister to you that you can get a message from the throne of God. Some of us take a message from everywhere. We want to thank God for the weather. We had a beautiful day today.
Amen.
And we can say it like this. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad therein. Come on, you that are listening, you got to rejoice. When the day like this, you got to praise him. If it's snowing, still praise him, because he made the day, and the scientist who has the power that they're trying to demonstrate could not do that. If you look up above your head and you see that sky, the scientists can't put it there. Mm-hmm. They don't know. They can't send rain. They can't send sun. They can't do nothing. But the word of God and the songwriters say, Jesus can do everything. Why don't you trust him? Accept him as your personal savior. Get a change of mind today and let us know that you listen to the program and you change your mind. You want to follow Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You know, and I sit here and I'm thinking, and I'm, you know, because you know, I just use this scripture here. You know, you have something to prove that is good and something that is acceptable and perfect, and it had to be the will of God. This is why the Bible says a double-minded man is unstable
in all his ways.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
A double-minded man. I like that.
Yes, because if you're double-minded, nothing is perfect. If you're double-minded, you will not be in God's will. If you're double-minded, you are incapable of accepting things that are true.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And
the word of God
go ahead.
Is phenomenal.
Phenomenal. I like that.
Yes. Yes.
Because he also says about that man, let not that man think that I even... listening to him because he's unstable, he's shifty.
Yes.
You know, God is, you know, God is really wisdom.
And you know, people are saying that God's word is confusing. The thing about it is that every part of God's word meshes together.
Sooner or later.
In your mind, your transformed mind. This is why he can have us to sit down here, because of some type of transformation in our mind, we can break this down a little.
In that same chapter 12, verse 16, well, you hit it. It says, be of the same mind.
Yes.
One toward another.
Yeah.
And you know, be of the same mind, and then it's used in the verb category.
Yes.
Mind not high
things,
but condescend to men of low degree. And that, Lewis said, that comes after you've been transformed.
Mm-hmm.
Then you can do that.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Be not wise in your own conceit. And that is. Do we love the scientists? I love the scientists.
Oh my God.
But the scientist that is wise in his or her own conceit.
God bless you, Pastor.
Then you bust in hell wide open.
Unfolded.
You understand?
God bless you.
Amen.
You have to be wise, knowing who God is. Don't do things your own way.
No.
There is a way that seemeth right unto man, but the end thereof
are the ways
of death. And when we, the Apostle Paul, I love the Apostle Paul so much. He says he was giving him transformation. And because of what he was getting, he said, I was given a thorn in the flesh that I may not get that uppity, that way that I think I know everything.
Amen.
In order to break that down, he gave him a thorn in the flesh.
Yes.
I tell you, I don't know. I think I experienced it a little bit. Oh,
touch
God.
Jesus.
Jesus. Hallelujah. My God.
Amen.
And you know what it does? You know, pain could take your mind away.
Yes.
You know, pain could really trouble your mind. Mm-hmm. Pain could really trouble your mind.
Amen.
But when you're laying with him and you have the pain and you say, Jesus, because he said he would be right there with you.
Amen.
Helping you.
Amen.
You know, so I thank God tonight. I thank God for this topic.
You ever see that in your things that you fear mm-hmm. the most is what kills you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Simply because mm-hmm. if you have fear in your mind, automatically it destroys the heart.
That's why. Shut up and don't say what. Hello. Shut up and don't say, because the power of the of death and life is in
the tongue. The tongue.
Stop
Amen.
Putting it out there, and the imps and they go on and run with it, and then you get set up.
Yeah, set
Keep
up.
It down.
Yes.
Don't utter it.
Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus.
You still have time to call us on the radio right now.
We must
347-663-8638. We want you to call. We want people to know that you are listening and that we wants to help you. Mm-hmm. You can testify on the radio.
Yes.
You can read the scripture verse for us, but just make sure that you're doing it with a set mind.
Yes.
Set upon God.
Set upon
Come
God.
On, take your phone set and your call mind. The office right now. When we make an announcement, we'll give you some other numbers to contact, and we're getting ready to let you know what you can do to change your mind.
Change your mind.
By setting your affection upon Jehovah God.
We have to remember that the mind is the ruling part
yes.
of the human
yes.
being.
We have to remember that.
We have to remember yeah. that the mind is the ruling part of the human
yeah.
being.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
first of all, we got to surrender that mind to get a breakthrough.
Yes, yes.
And unless that is a surrendered mind, mm-hmm. you will be messed up for the rest of your life.
And right now we could thank God for Minister yes. Stryker.
Yes.
God changed his mind.
Mm-hmm.
And look at what he's doing mm-hmm. now. Look at mm-hmm. where we are right now because of God working, transforming him. And we are here on the radio. We can help you.
Mm-hmm.
We can talk to you. We can reason with you. And most of all, we can pray with you and know the God that we are praying to. We are praying to a God because we pray the effectual, fervent, prayer of a righteous man. Our minds have been transformed. And when we say we are righteous, we are not beating our backs or chests.
No.
We can't do that.
No.
The Apostle Paul says we can't do that.
Mm-mm.
He says, because it's by the grace of God,
Amen.
I am what I am. But I know what I am.
Amen.
And I know who I am.
Yes, yes.
Because I'm striving and I'm not looking back. I'm going forward.
Amen.
And we can help you. Call us 347-663-8638.
And we must.
Hallelujah.
Go ahead.
If we have our mind renewed,
mm-hmm.
then we're going to be spiritually minded.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible says that if we set our mind on the things of the Spirit,
mm-hmm.
that we're going to be walking in accordance with the Spirit, right?
Amen.
And then the Bible also tells us that we fight not against flesh and blood.
Mm-hmm.
If we're not fighting against flesh and blood, it's a spiritual warfare.
Yeah,
if it's a spiritual warfare, the only way we're going to be able to fight in that spiritual warfare is if we're spiritually minded. And the only way you're spiritually minded is if you are being renewed. If you're allowing yourself to set your minds on the things of God, if you're allowing yourself to seek God's face, seek His righteousness, seek His word, and practice, meditate on it.
Hallelujah.
Let me back you up. A changed mind.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Bring spirituality.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Amen.
A changed mind bring renewed faith.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Amen.
A changed mind makes you a stronger person.
Amen.
Oh, yeah.
A better person.
Yes, yeah.
Yes. A lively person. Mm-hmm. A person with hope.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Yes.
A person with expectations.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
A
Amen.
Person who could love God with all your Hallelujah. Heart and all Amen. Your mind and all your spirit and all your soul.
Hallelujah. Amen.
A changed mind is a breakthrough for deliverance.
The Amen. Woman at the well had one.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes. The yes. woman at the well had one. Mm-hmm. And Amen. Jesus told her, the Father desires such to worship him. You have to worship him in spirit. She when had she, a change.
When she changed her mind, she ran.
Oh my God.
Come see a man.
Amen. Let's do.
She ran. She ran. You out there, when you change your mind, you're going to run. You're going to feel good because you can tell somebody else, yes, man. You
Amen.
Can tell somebody about
Goodness
Jesus
of God.
Because
Hallelujah.
You have a mind change.
Yes.
My God. Mm-hmm. Amen. Yeah. We know that we are giving you justice.
Yes.
And the amazing thing is that some of us have to have a forced change of mind.
Yes.
When I think about Paul,
yes, sir.
Yeah. Paul had a forced
yes, sir.
Change of mind.
Amen.
God have to knock him down.
Yes, sir. Yes. Amen.
Knock him out. Mm-hmm. Silence him
yes, sir.
To change him.
Yes, sir. Amen.
But oh, what a change.
What a powerful change.
What a powerful Amen. Change. Amen. What a Amen. Powerful change. Hallelujah.
Don't let God have to come take you up from your bed. You have the chance now. Don't let him have to take you up there. You have a mind. You have a change. You have a mindset chance. Now.
Yeah.
You can get a mind change, a transformation. Just call.
Yeah.
If you need help, we are here to help
we're
you.
Here to help.
Amen. You can do it right where you're sitting, just by your radio, just by your television,
yes.
just by your computer.
Yeah.
You can listen and you can make a change. Mm-hmm. Change your mind.
Change
Walk
your
with God.
Yes.
Serve God.
Mm-hmm.
We are talking to people here that the church too small to hold. So find a good gospel church. When you change your mind and you're living too far from faith life, find a good gospel
Amen.
Church. When you go to tell them, faith life people send you because they preach to you, they talk about the mind change, and you want to worship God.
Hallelujah.
You want to serve him. You got to serve him.
Hallelujah.
And Bishop, I'm being honest.
Mm-hmm.
I'm getting down to the believer now.
Okay.
If you get saved and you don't have a change of mind, you're faking it.
Mm-hmm.
Because when we look around and because, listen, without a change of mind, you cannot have true love.
No.
You cannot have
it's impossible.
True love.
But
sure.
Pastor, you don't believe when you get saved, you get a change of mind one time, automatically?
Not a full change of mind.
Okay.
Process.
It's a process.
It's a process. Yes.
It's a process.
I agree with
okay.
that. Yes.
It's a process.
It's
you know, that's why he says, let,
yes.
let its future.
Yeah. Amen.
Let this
the
mind.
Choice. Choice. Mm-hmm.
So you
yes.
have to, you have to take that process to get that mind change.
That's right.
Because it's letting it happen.
Yes.
Okay.
You have to let it happen.
Mm-hmm.
You just don't get it.
No.
Amen.
Paul didn't even just get it.
That's correct.
Because God had to make him dumb and leave him to rest for a while.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And he still had the temptation because it's a change.
It's a change.
It's a letting.
Yeah.
It's a letting go. It's a letting go and accepting the change that's going to take place.
Mm-hmm.
When
you get saved, you just have a change of spirit.
Of spirit. Yes, as many as believed him, to them gave he the power
to become
the Son of God.
Get ready. We need your help. We need you to change your mind and come preach this gospel with us.
Mm-hmm.
We need you to go to the street. We need you to go to the marketplace, the subway, and preach this gospel. So come on and get ready and change your mind. Call us. We can help you. 347-663-8638. Remember, this is your life, your salvation. It's your choice. Why don't you make a good choice tonight and get a change of heart, a change of mind, and you're going to be rejoicing.
Hallelujah.
And praising the name of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. This coming Friday in our deliverance service, we have a special speaker. We are going headbang because we want you to come. Mark it on your calendar. Come up with us on Friday to our deliverance service. We praise God. We salute all our radio team partners. Pastor Pitt, who is home.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Sister Whistlin and Brother Akim, we salute you on tonight. And even those of our listeners in Grenada and Trinidad, we salute you in Canada, wherever you are in the world, listening to the Hour of Prayer and Choice Radio. You can't go wrong. We thank God for this studio, and we pray that God will expand the borders of this radio station, that men and women can come to know Christ as Savior, as Redeemer. Amen. Pastor, so stay tuned.
Go ahead. Pastor Bash, you know, I was talking about if you don't have a change of mind, you can't have love. Let's look at verse 9 in Romans 12.
All right.
What does it say?
Let love be without dissimulation.
What is dissimulation? Dissimulation is with lack of affection.
Hypocrisy. Yes.
You know?
But that's true, you know, Pastor. Because remember, it's human being you're dealing with. Remember what Pastor Pitt says? You're a human being first
and a Christian after.
And that's why Paul says, what I would that I do not. You think it's easy to love people?
Because to love people, you have to have a change of mind.
I think it's important that we can read the whole verse.
Yes. Without dissimulation, abhor that which is evil. What does abhor mean?
Oh my God.
It's turn away.
Turn away.
To hate.
Hate.
Disallow.
Disallow.
Amen.
And to cleave that which is good.
That's it.
So a change of mind brings a cleaving to that which is good.
Yes. It does.
And when we talk about that which is good, we are talking about John 3:16.
Yes.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Amen. That whosoever believeth. Did you remember what the songwriter said? What a friend
we have in Jesus.
All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything. Everything. We can go to God tonight. You don't have to wonder. You don't have to be scared. We can go to God. God loves you, and he wants to change your mind.
Yes.
But he's waiting on you because he gave us a free will.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. We have a choice.
We can.
To change your mind around and serve God.
Yes, Pastor, you asked a question about how you can't do that without, because when you think about human beings and how they affect you, but you said it just now, when you accept Jesus, you get a change of spirit. And when his spirit is working in you, you know when you do something wrong.
Exactly.
Amen.
I couldn't live a piece of this Christian life unless I had the Spirit of God in me. Not only in me, but working at work in me. Because when I do something wrong, it gnaws at my spirit.
Amen.
And I have to go and say, like David, I repent. God, forgive me.
That's the letting.
Amen.
That's the letting.
So
letting
when I treat somebody,
transform your mind.
You never passed somebody on the road,
yes,
and your mind kind of said, "Give that person something," but you passed,
yes,
and then you go back,
yes.
Have you ever done that?
Yes.
The mind.
Yes.
Right in that second,
Jesus,
the Spirit of God says,
yes,
turn around,
yes,
and do what you know you're supposed to do.
Amen.
And then when you leave that person, you leave with more joy.
Yes. Amen.
More joy. That's why some of us have been running up and down, and because we like the woman at the well. We have been transformed. And we know what transformation means.
Amen.
It's a beautiful thing. And that's why David says it's sweeter than honey and the honeycomb. Taste and see that the Lord is good. We still have a few minutes. 347-663-8638. Call and we'll pray with you and make sure you have a good night's sleep. Hallelujah.
The transformed mind will help you to accomplish a saving change in your life.
Big words.
Help you to accomplish. Because you have to continue.
Yes,
you have to continue in it.
You have to he that endureth to the end shall be saved. Don't fool yourself, you know. Don't worry to fool yourself. You know, do the word of God says what it says.
It says what it says.
Get into the word, like Sister Monifa says. Get into the word. Get into the word. The word was made flesh.
And dwelt
among us. And we beheld its glory.
Amen.
The glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. The word is what gonna keep us.
Amen.
Why run from it? Run into it and be saved.
Amen.
And know
Amen.
What?
I just want to warn you outside there that are listening. If you know the Lord, if you're having problem, do not stay in your house and feel you can worship God at home. Find a full gospel church. The Bible says, do not forsake the assembling of yourselves. You have to serve one another. You got to help somebody that somebody can help you. Get a change of mind. I speak with a young man yesterday and was so disappointed in him. He said, if he died, he don't care how they bury him.
Mm.
He don't care because he already make right with God. He believe in God, but he don't believe in church. He don't believe in nothing else. And we cannot do it like this. We got to think about people. You got to love people and as you love yourself. That's what the word of God says. Mm-hmm. So let us remember, change your mind from the thought, the evil thoughts, the evil thinking. Change your mind. And let God give you a brand new mind.
And one thing I want to say, as your mind begin to change, it will. Trust me, because God is changing my mind even as I'm talking to you guys.
Hallelujah.
The more I spend time in His Word, the more I'm at awe with everything. The more I look at things so differently. And the more you want to truly be like Him, it's not just saying that you want to be like Him. It's you truly passionate. You have zeal to be like Him. And the more you're aiming to be like Him and you're spending time in His Word, the more you're going to know that the enemy is going to come to attack your mind.
Mm-hmm.
But even in those moments, you have to keep praying. You have to keep seeking. You cannot give up. When you're being attacked, you have to be steadfast in those moments. Because in those moments, that's when God get the glory. Because He will deliver you when you are steadfast, even when you are being attacked. Because you will be attacked. So don't think it's going to be easy.
Mm-mm.
It definitely will not be.
Definitely.
When you have a transformed, renewed mind, some things happen.
Mm-hmm.
Your understanding is enlightened.
Mm.
Your conscience is softened.
Excellent.
Good your word. Thoughts are rectified.
Yes, sir.
So it's a complete change.
Complete change. Complete.
Your thoughts
transformation
changes.
Yes.
You think differently.
Ooh. Yeah.
You think love and you think kindness.
Amen.
And
you give away your money.
you
forsake and you work.
You forsake yourself for your brother.
Yes,
sir. Amen, amen, amen. Because we are brother's keeper.
Yes, sir.
And the thing about that is that when we forsake ourselves for our brothers or keepers, God will bless us.
Yes.
And with the renewed mind we have, we don't ring a bell when we do something.
No.
Left hand doesn't know what right hand
is doing.
Because you see, if left hand get to know, well, we get nothing. Yeah. We already rewarded.
Yes.
But with the change of mind, secretly, we do our thing.
Amen.
And we are happy while we do it.
Amen.
We give cheerfully. Hallelujah.
Amen. We got some announcement that we want you to hear because they are so important that we do not want you to miss them.
Yes.
Tomorrow, God's willing, Wednesday, and every Wednesday is our Bible class. We thank God for our teacher, Pastor Pitt. He's going to be teaching still in the book of Revelation. Come out on tomorrow. And then on Friday, this is a special deliverance service.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Come, bring the sick, your aunt, your neighbor, the deaf, the dumb.
Yeah.
We're going to be praying and seeking God for your deliverance.
Mm-hmm.
And then on Saturday morning at 6 a.m., we gather at the church for pray. Amen. We people call us from New Jersey, from Queens, all over, because we people need prayer. Yes. So we want you to call us and let us know your request, and we can take it up on Saturday morning in our prayer room. And listen, at this same time, if you're in your home, you got a home, you got something you want us to bless, you want us to come to your house and keep a cottage meeting, we're going to give you a number. Call us and let us know. We'll set an appointment and we will come. And you know we don't usually advertise and announce our Sunday school, but listen, man, we have a teacher that God has been using in a supernatural way. Amen. I'm so proud of that lady, because she allowed God to change her mind and get into the Word. Every Sunday morning at 11 a.m. you can come. Sunday school, 45 minutes. And listen, it's a bucket of 45 minutes there. She puts everything in one and she gives you, thus said the Lord. I heard this woman bring out some truth. Amen. About the five talent. God bless her. Amen. So we want you to come out and join us, and our worship service is 11:45. And listen, Sunday morning, don't miss it. Don't miss it. We still in our complimentary ministry. Two ministers, amen, going to be speaking, and Sunday you will never regret. So listen, come out and be with us in our Sunday morning service. And we want you to know God has something in store. Amen. And remember this, if you have any problem, any legal problem, immigration, whatever it is, get in touch with us. We have the right attorney who will not rob you of your money, and we will try to help you. Listen, the numbers to call for any one of these things is 718-773-7515. That number again, 718-773-7515. Or you can get us on the cell, 347-444-6986. That number, 347-444-6986. Remember, God has something. You want counseling? We give you free counseling. We don't charge you a cent. Come, call us and let us know. You need help with your marriage. You need help with your drug addict. You need help with your alcoholic son, a wife, a daughter. Call us. We plan to help you. No charge to that. We do it as unto the Lord. Amen. So we want you to come and let the Lord have his way. Join us in our Bible class on tomorrow and Sunday morning at 11 a.m. our Sunday school. Man, you will be blessed and go rejoicing.
Hallelujah. Amen. And that address is
844 Clarkson Avenue. That's between East 51st and Utica. You can get the number 3. You can go to Eastern Parkway and take the 46 to Winthrop. Walk down and you will see on your left going down, you will see
Domino
Pizza. Just walk in, and the right hand side you will see the church.
Amen.
844 Clarkson Avenue between East 51st and Utica. That caller that said tonight she's going to be there on Sunday, we're going to be waiting for you with open arms to welcome you in the kingdom of God. Amen. In the church of God, we got good ushers that stay by the door, talk to you and encourage you to be in the service. So stay tuned and let God have its way in your life.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
To deliver thee, he is able to deliver. to the sinful soul. But to God in faith, He will make me whole. Our God is able to deliver me. Oh, He is able to deliver me. He's able, able, able to deliver me. So my sin or prayer, come to Him for rest. Our God is able to deliver me.
Hallelujah.
This CD that you dress here, you can get in touch with us if you need a copy. This is a daughter of mine, a woman that I ordained and going for the Lord, and she is singing the praising of the Lord. So if you need a copy of that record, you heard a few songs tonight, you can get in touch with us at the same number that we gave you, 718-773-7515, or you can call me on the cell, 347-444-6986. Remember, you are supporting a good and worthy cause, mm-hmm. buying a copy of this CD that you hear us played on tonight. God bless you. Stay tuned. Let God have His way in your life.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. So we want you to know, we come to the end of this program. We are so happy. We thank God for the callers tonight.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. God bless you. And we want you to know, this is Amen. Your bishop, your friend, your brother, Bishop Vincent, saying have a good time in the Lord. Remember, I love you, and there is nothing you can do about it.
Hallelujah. This is Pastor Bash. It's been a pleasure being here with you this evening. I thank God for each and every one of you, those that called in, those that didn't call in. And I just pray, God, that, you know, He will continue to be with you, changing your mind.
Amen.
As Sister Monifa said, continue with you, changing your mind. In Jesus' name, God bless you.
Good night, Radio Land. This is Sister Monifa. It was nice being with you guys tonight. And I pray that you guys will let your mind be renewed. Remember, yes. It's a choice.
It's a choice.
Good night.
Amen. You just want to close up this.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen, Pastor. Father, we thank you tonight.
Everyone that listen to this program, we pray, God, those that want to be saved, those that
yes,
want
Jesus.
To come to the Lord, just change their mind and give them a peace. Bless them
mm-hmm.
in Jesus' name. Bless this studio again.
Mm-hmm.
Amen and amen.
Those are you that in your home right now, you have not accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, or you are backslider and,
yes.
and you are not serving God in spirit and in truth right about this time, I want you to just put your
yes.
hands on your radio, put
yes.
it on your heart, put it on your mind, because we're talking about a change of mind.
Yes.
And if you want to change your mind and your spirit tonight,
yes.
we're going to ask you to just say this prayer after us, because it takes only a second
yes, Lord.
To receive Jesus.
Yes.
As we continue saying, the man on the cross,
yes.
he was transformed immediately. Please repeat after me. Say, oh God.
Oh God.
I'm grateful that you kept me this far.
That you kept me this far.
I'm a sinner. And want to be saved.
Father,
deliver me.
And set me free.
From all my wickedness.
From all my sin.
And take me into your kingdom. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
That is all it takes.
Hallelujah.
That's all it takes. an acceptance of the of that prayer from your heart, and God will bless you. Hallelujah. This is Pastor Atwell saying, I am so grateful to be with you on another Tuesday night, and I thank God for all the listeners and all the people who are out there listening to us. We are grateful for your listening ear. We thank God tonight, and as I leave this program, I just want to say to you, grace, mercy, and peace be unto you from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Yes. Be blessed till we meet again. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.